Good morning, and welcome to the Pentecostals of Lee Road. I'm Zachary Kleindienst, and I'm excited to have the honor of welcoming you this morning. Whether you are a member of our church family or you're a first-time guest or viewer on our live stream, we're excited that you're joining us this morning as we come together as a church body to worship the Lord. Psalm 19 tells us that the heavens declare the glory of God. As we're gathered here this morning on this live stream as a community of believers and as individuals, privately, individually, seeking God in our own relationship with Him, it's times like this that we can gather together and declare the glory of God. Join us as we worship God and as we seek the Lord, both as a communal body and also as individuals. Worship with us.
Seen that you On weeknights at 7 p.m., tune into Facebook Live and join Pastor Jathan for an enriching and encouraging time of devotion. Our Bible study groups have gone virtual. Visit us at polr.org to sign up for a Bible study group. Take advantage of this by inviting friends or family members to join a Bible study from the comfort of their own home. Join us at 10 a.m. on Zoom to be a part of our daily prayer calls. These calls are an opportunity to stay united in prayer as we seek God for our country, community, and church family.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Holy, holy.
Hallelujah.
Holy, holy.
You are worthy.
Of my praise.
Of my praise.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Holy, holy.
You are worthy.
Of my praise.
Of my praise.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Holy, holy.
During this transition, we wanted to make you aware that we have two ways for you to give. You can give online at polr.org. You can also mail in your tithes and offering, or you can bring them by the church at 17700 Highway 40, Covington, Louisiana. We understand that there is a lot of uncertainties during this time. There's a lot of questions and concerns that each of us have. But what we understand is that we serve a faithful God. Furthermore, we know that as a community of believers, this is a faithful church. And we want to take a moment here to acknowledge each and every one of you of the faithfulness that you've had, not only in giving of your tithes and your offering, but also your faithfulness of joining this body of believers, whether it's watching our live stream or it's joining our morning Zoom calls or it's getting on Facebook Live, whatever it is, this church body has come together in an unprecedented way. You're a faithful church, and we're excited of what God is doing here at the Pentecostals of Lee Road. At this time, Bishop is going to come and deliver a word from the Lord. Get ready to hear what God has to speak to your family during this time. God bless.
Good morning. It's good to be with you on this great Sunday morning. What a beautiful day it is. It's always a beautiful day. Don't matter what the weather's like. It's just a beautiful day to be awake and alive and to be in the presence of the Lord. We're coming to you today from POLR, wonderful church, wonderful people, meeting with you on the internet. And so we're so glad you're gathered in your living room or maybe driving down the highway. We just pray that the word of the Lord helps you today. I'm going to be speaking to you today from a subject that the Lord dropped into my spirit a few days ago. And the title of my message today is, What God is Saying. It is extremely vital to hear what the Lord is saying in this day and time. David and his men returned from battle to find their families taken captive. Their possessions were stolen and their hometown burned to the ground. Nothing but rubble. Nothing but pain hit them. They were looking forward to some rest, but they came home to nothing. The question hit their mind, what now? After doing the will of God, what now? In David's low state, even his men threatened to stone him. They were loyal men, but at this time, they spake of stoning their leader. There are times we just don't know what to do. You ever been there? Everywhere we look, there's devastation, discontent, and frustration. It's one thing to be fighting this COVID-19, and then we have tornadoes everywhere, and then there's other situations on the horizon. So David sought the Lord, and God said, round up your men and go take back everything that's yours. And so they did. That's kind of the way I feel this morning. I'm ready to rise up and go take back what I feel Satan stole from us. How about you? Why is it important to hear what God is saying now? God doesn't always say what we think he might say. We can't guess about it. We've got to know for sure. He doesn't always speak the same way each time. He doesn't always say it the same way. One time he told Moses to strike the rock, but the next time he said, speak to the rock. One battle, the Lord told David, charge. The next battle, he said, stay still until you hear the wind blowing and the top of the mulberry trees. I want to hear what Jesus Christ has said now. How about you? Revelation 2:11 says, he that hath an ear, let him hear what the Spirit says to the churches. We're privileged to be called out of darkness, hallelujah, into this marvelous light. The world is reeling to and fro like a drunken man. The absolute truth is the safest place for us to be today is in the body of Christ, with an ear to hear what he is saying to his church. So what am I hearing the Lord Jesus Christ say to me right now? I hear him say, rest in my peace. Rest in my peace. In John 14:27, Jesus says, "Peace I leave with you. My peace I give to you, not as the world giveth, not as the world giveth, but I give it to you. Let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid." And then he says in John 16:33, "These things I have spoken to you, that in me you might have peace. In the world you shall have tribulation, but be of good cheer. I have overcome the world." The peace Jesus gives is a special kind that only comes from His Spirit. Philippians 4:7 says, "And the peace of God, which passeth all understanding, shall keep your hearts and minds through Jesus Christ." You can't get this kind of a peace in some kind of meditation in your own mind. It doesn't come from self-medicating yourself. You can't get it through alcohol. You can't get it through chemicals you could put in your body. Nor does it come by seeking sexual pleasures or pursuing financial security. Solomon, who was the wisest man that ever lived, wrote about all he pursued and accomplished in his lifetime. He obtained men servants and maid servants, fine dining and rich and famous guests who came bearing lavish gifts to him of gold and gems and famous jewels. He planted stunning gardens and extravagant homes. He even married 1,000 wives. Imagine that. And whatever he desired, he pursued and he obtained. Yet in his conclusion, he writes, "It was all emptiness and confusion." And then he says, "It was vanity and vexation of my mind, my body, my soul, and my spirit." I want to ask you, what are you fretting about today? What are you pursuing? What is grieving you and occupying your mind? What's keeping you up at night? And what is chewing up your hours in your days? In this world, we will have trouble. We will have tribulation. We may feel we have to fight for survival. But I tell you, fight on. Stay on. Pray on. We must battle against anxiety and fear and anger and offense and hostility and depression and warlike people. But right in the middle of all of this chaos, right in the middle of all of this chaos, there is Jesus Christ, who promised us peace in this world that the world cannot give. A peace that comes from your heart through your Holy Spirit. In John 14:26, he wrote, "The Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost, who the Father will send in my name, he shall teach you all things." Romans 14:17, one of my favorite scriptures. "For the kingdom of God is not meat and drink, but righteousness and peace." Did you hear me? "And peace and joy in the Holy Ghost. If you have not received His Spirit, it is for each of you." In Acts 2:38, Peter tells a hungry seeker how to receive the Holy Spirit. He said, "First, you must repent." It just means to turn your life over to Jesus Christ, to let Him know that you're sorry for your sins and you're seeking your own path. And you ask Him to forgive you of your sins, and then let Him take the wheel of your life. And then next, after you repent, you should be water baptized in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission, for the removal of your sins. And then you shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. I'm making a call to you today. If you haven't been born again of water and spirit, I'm offering you an opportunity today. If you are sitting in your living room, just sit there and that couch or in that chair and raise your hands and say, Jesus, forgive me of my sins. Have mercy upon me and come into my life. And then after you repent of your sins, say, Lord, I'm willing to find a church and be baptized in water in Jesus' name for the remission of my sins. If you'll give me the Holy Ghost till I can get there, and then just begin to say, hallelujah, I love you, Jesus. And then it won't take but a moment. Your tongue will start saying things you don't know. Just let it go, for you will be receiving the gift of the Holy Ghost. And with that comes a peace that passes all understanding. You'll be the happiest day of your life. Promise of the Holy Ghost for you and your children and to those who are far off. Right now, where you are, just ask the Lord Jesus Christ to come and fill you with His Heavenly Spirit. I hear Jesus saying right now these words. I hear Him say, son, come rest with me, and I'm fixing to be done with my message for you this morning. And they will come with a song, and then you can pray again if you haven't prayed already. I hear Jesus telling me today, son, come rest with me. Aren't you a little bit weary? Aren't you kind of tired of hearing all the bad news on the radio and on the television? Aren't you just kind of tired of hearing people talk about all the sad things and the bad things? Aren't you ready for a little peace in your life? Well, Jesus said in Matthew 11, 28 and 29, He said, come unto me, all you that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. And then He didn't stop there. He said, take my yoke upon you and learn of me, for I am meek and lowly in heart, and you shall find rest for your souls. Did you hear what He said? And you shall find rest for your souls. Don't that sound heavenly? Listen, sometimes they say it sounds too good to be true. And if it sounds too good to be true, it is too good to be true. But listen to me. This statement by Jesus isn't too good to be true. It's the truth, because the truth said it. And when He spoke it, He had you in His mind. Jesus saw you thousands of years ago. He knew right where we would be at this time in our life. And He said, I'll speak into my people. It's time to rest. And so as I close out with one last scripture, so what is God's conclusion for the peace dilemma in 2020? The writer in 2 Thessalonians 1:7 said, and to you that are troubled, come rest with us. He is saying there are some people out there that believe the Bible, and they're my church. And He said, I want you to find them. If you're driving somewhere or you're somewhere living and you got more trouble than you got answers, I want to tell you, you've tried everything in the world you can try. You owe it to yourself to try the Spirit of Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus, we're praying right now that people will come to repentance, that people will come to you and find rest for their souls. In Jesus' name, amen.
I give you glory for all you've brought me through. And now I'm ready for whatever you want to do. I'm moving forward. An open door. We want you, Lord, like never before. Your presence is an open door. So come now, Lord, like never before. In every season, your grace has been enough. like never before. Your presence is an open door. We want you, Lord, like never before.
Come on, fill the room with praise. Set off the atmosphere, shift it with your